Hello students, I am Aparna Kedari and I am working as assistant professor in Department of Chemistry, Sarat College of Art, Commerce and Science. Today we are going to study stereochemistry and now today's topic is chair and board conformation of cyclohexane. First, this is chair conformation of cyclohexane. In this chair conformation, this is the chair means this four carbon. Suppose this carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This four carbon atom, that is carbon number 2, 3, 5 and 6 are in average plane. And this first carbon is above the plane, above this average plane. And this fourth carbon is below the average plane. This is the chair conformation of cyclohexane. Then next conformation of cyclohexane is boat conformation. This is the boat conformation of cyclohexane. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 carbon atoms in this. The carbon number 2, carbon number 3 and carbon number 5 and carbon number 6 are in average plane and both carbon 1 and carbon 4 is above the average plane. Then this conformation is called boat conformation and it is represented like that, like this. Then next, ring flipping. What is ring flipping? When one form of chair is converted into another chair is called as ring flipping. After ring flipping, the axial bonds becomes equatorial and equatorial bonds becomes axial. Here this yellow bonds, sorry, gray, blue bonds or blue hydrogens are axial and these red hydrogens are equatorial. That is, this axial hydrogens means the they are perpendicular to this average plane. This axial hydrogen means they are perpendicular to axial this average plane, and equatorial bonds means they are projecting outward and they are parallel to this average plane. Therefore, these axial hydrogens are the perpendicular to average plane and this equatorial hydrogens are projecting outward and they are parallel to this average plane of carbon 2, 3, 5 and 6. There are total 6 axial hydrogens in cyclohexane and 6 equatorial hydrogen. And when this ring flipping takes place, the axial hydrogen becomes equatorial and equatorial hydrogen becomes axial. That is, all this blue hydrogens becomes equatorial, which are axially placed in first conformation, and this red hydrogens are changes to axial hydrogens. And but in this case, the above bonds remains above and below bonds remains below, and after ring flipping, the axial bond becomes equatorial and equatorial bonds becomes axial. Then next is the comparison of chair conformation and boat conformation. In chair conformation, the hydrogen atoms and two adjacent carbon atoms are staggered carbon atoms, and hence the torsional strain is minimum and the strain-free conformation can be verified by Newman projection. This is the chair conformation of cyclohexane and this is the Newman representation of this chair conformation. This is carbon 1. Suppose we observe from this side, then this carbon is first carbon, two carbon is this circle is second carbon, then third carbon, fifth, then fourth carbon is this circle, and this fifth carbon is this circle point, and this is sixth carbon. This is the Newman projection. In this Newman projection, all hydrogens and all the CH2 groups are goes to each other. And this is second one is the boat conformation. Suppose we observe from this carbon 1 and carbon 5, this is the Newman projection and draw the Newman projection. Then this Newman projection becomes all these hydrogen and CH2 groups are eclipsed with each other. And here this carbon number 1, then here carbon, this circle is the carbon number 2. And this is 3, carbon number 3, then circle is carbon number 4, then this fifth is circle point and sixth is this sixth carbon. This is the Newman projection of both conformation of cyclohexene. Then observation, the both conformations of higher energy content, both conformation is of higher energy content than the new chair conformation due to the presence of interactions. There are some interactions, and the first interaction is C2 hydrogens are eclipsed with C3 hydrogens and C6 hydrogens are eclipsed with C5 hydrogens. Here, if we see this C2 hydrogen and C1 hydrogens are eclipsing with each other, and this C3 and C5 hydrogen, sorry, C4 and C5 hydrogens are eclipsing with each other. Therefore, there are two sets of hydrogens are eclipsing with each other, and the two hydrogens atoms attached to C1, C4 are known as flagpole hydrogen. That is, these two hydrogens are known as the flagpole hydrogens. They are close to each other, and these two hydrogens atoms try to repel with each other because some of the van der Waals radii bit of two hydrogen is 2.5 angstrom, but the distance available to accommodate these two flagpole hydrogens is only 1.8 angstrom. That is, they are more closer to each other, therefore they repel with each other, and such crowding is known as the van der Waals strain or van der Waals steric strain. Van der Waals strain or steric strain. Thus, torsional interaction and flagpole interaction increases the potential energy of both conformation, and this increase is up to 7.1 kilocalorie higher than the chair conformation. And in chair conformation, it is strain free. All atoms are staggered or close to each other. Therefore, there is zero kilocalorie energy of chair conformation and 7.1 kilocalorie is of boat conformation. They're higher than the chair conformation. Therefore, chair conformation is more stable conformation than boat conformation. Then next conformation of cyclohexane is twist boat conformation. Then this skew boat conformation is the modification of or modified form of boat conformation. In which the flagpole hydrogens are moved away, and therefore van der Waals strain or steric strain decreases. Similarly, the torsional interaction due to eclipsing hydrogens are also decreased to some extent, and such boat are known to skew or boat conformation. This boat conformation twisted, and due to this twisting, these flagpole hydrogens go away from each other, and therefore van der Waals strain decreases, also steric strain decreases, and it gives the skew boat conformation, or it is also called twist boat conformation. When the twist boat conformation has energy up to 5.5 kilocalorie and boat conformation has 7.1 kilocalorie. Therefore, skew boat conformation or twist boat conformation is more favorable conformation than boat conformation because it has less energy. Therefore, twist boat is more stable than boat, but it is less stable than the chair conformation, because chair conformation has zero kilocalorie energy. There is no steric interaction. The next conformation of cyclohexane is half chair conformation. When both bottom carbon of chair conformation is lifted upward, and so that five carbon, that is out of these six, five carbon atoms are in same plane and only one carbon atom is above the plane, such conformation is called half chair conformation, and it has an angle strain as well as torsional strain, and about 11 kilocalorie per mole energy above the chair conformation, because here a lot of angle strain is there between this, because of this five carbons in plane, and it is least stable conformation of cyclohexane, and therefore this is half chair conformation is least stable because its energy is 11 kilocalorie per mole. Then here the graphical representation of all forms of or all conformations of cyclohexane. Here chair conformation, there is no steric interaction, therefore energy is 0 kilocalorie per mole. Then here is the half chair conformation. Here five carbon atoms in one plane, therefore there is lot of angle strain and energy increases up to 11 kilocalorie per mole. Then this conformation is twist boat conformation. This twist boat conformation फ्लैगपोल इंटरैक्शंस और वंडरवाल्स इंटरैक्शंस आर रिमूव्ड, बट एनर्जी रिमेन्स 5.5 किलो कैलोरी पर मोल बिकॉज इट इज लेस देन बोट कॉन्फॉर्मेशन. देन हियर इज द बोट कॉन्फॉर्मेशन. देन बोट कॉन्फॉर्मेशन एनर्जी 6.5 किलो कैलोरी पर मोल बिकॉज देर आर सी टू सी थ्री हाइड्रोजन एंड सी फोर सी फाइव हाइड्रोजन आर इक्लिप्सिंग विथ इच अदर. ऑल्सो देर इज फ्लैगपोल हाइड्रोजन देर फोर energy increases up to 6.5 kilocalorie per mole. Then fist boat conformation, again first chair converted into half chair converted into twist boat or skew boat, and then it converted into boat again converted into twist boat, and again it converted into half chair, then half chair again converted into chair conformation. Here for half chair conformation energy increases up to 11 kilocalorie per mole due to the lot of angle strain when 5 carbon atoms becomes in one plane. This is about the potential energy relationship among the conformation. Therefore stability order of stability order of the cyclohexane chair conformation is more stable, and it has 0 kilocalorie per mole energy. Then next conformation is twist boat conformation. Its energy is 5.5 kilocalorie per mole. Then next conformation is boat conformation, 6.5 kilocalorie or up to 7.1 kilocalorie per mole. And then half chair conformation is 11 kilocalorie per mole. Therefore half chair conformation is the highest unstable form of or conformation of cyclohexane, and more stable conformation is the chair conformation.